I'm Robert W. Morgan. This week on the Special of the Week, a lesson in survival from Gloria Gaynor. Gloria's survival seemed assured back in 1975 when she was voted Queen of the Discos, thanks to such foot stompers as Never Can Say Goodbye. But when Gloria said goodbye to America and toured the world, she was nearly dethroned back home. That's why I Will Survive is more than a great Gloria Gaynor song. It's the story of her life. Gloria Gaynor, this week on the Special of the Week. This week on the Special of the Week, Gloria Gaynor.
I never can say goodbye.
Gloria Gaynor, living proof of the survival of the fittest.
I'm the kind of person that adversity just really makes me stronger. It makes me more determined. I mean, I will survive.
I will survive.
Gloria Gaynor, this week on the Robert W. Morgan Special of the Week. The coronation of Her Majesty the Queen.
And enthroned forever in our hearts, the Queen.
I'm Robert W. Morgan. This week on the Special of the Week, Long Live the Queen. Most queens are anointed, but she was appointed. It was back in 1975 when disco was struggling back to its feet. And of the entire crop of new disco artists, only she had harvested a pop audience as well. In recognition of that feat, the National Association of Discotheque Disc Jockeys voted her Queen of the Discos. But that coronation wasn't her only crowning achievement. It was survival. Survival in a business which nearly dethroned her. Today, she reigns supreme. A true queen. Gloria Gaynor.
For the first time in my life, I found the man for me. He's the man who makes me feel just like a queen. For the first time in my life, I found my destiny. And I'll be whatever he wants me to be.
I feel when I'm performing, when I walk out onto a stage, I feel just like you feel when your wife or your friend or someone else has let your guests into your home and you walk in later after they're already seated. That's exactly how I feel. Good evening, how are you? We're gonna have a good time together tonight.
Gaynor. She keeps dancers on their toes, thanks to lyrics that are as provocative as her melodies. Music may be challenging for dancers, but most disco lyrics are about as challenging as a TV guide crossword puzzle. I mean, just how many ways are there to say boogie? Gloria, on the other hand, looks for meaningful messages in her songs, forcing her audiences into thinking fast on their feet.
Well, I tell you, I don't dislike those songs. I like those songs. I like Boogie Oogie Oogie. It had a message, but I just think the message has been overdone. I mean, everybody's saying dance. I mean, how many times do you have to tell people that? I don't think they need me to help them tell people to dance. There are enough of them doing that. Now, I like letting the producer and the musicians inspire them to dance. I try to inspire them to think, to love each other while they're dancing, to think about their problems on a positive level, rather than escape and take a total vacation from your problems and pretend they aren't there. Just think about them on a positive level and come up with solutions, and maybe just relax from them for a few minutes.
Later in the hour, we'll take a good look at one of Gloria's greatest hits, I Will Survive, and we'll find out why it succeeds as both music and poetry. Gloria's own survival instinct demands that she record songs which work on all possible levels. Her stubbornness on that score has won her the respect and admiration of other artists, artists who might otherwise be cool to disco, artists like Roberta Flack.
You know, the biggest disco hits are not the ones that make sense. Although, with Gloria Gaynor's record, that's changed things a little bit too, because that sounds like a French art song, like one of those things that if Edith Piaf had been living, she could have sung with the same, disco rhythm thing and probably done a great job. I Will Survive, you know, as long as I know how to love, I know I'll stay alive. I mean, I love that. But, of course, 95% of what you hear in the discos doesn't sound like that. But if it's going to last, it will have to. If somebody had offered me that song that Gloria Gaynor sings, I would have sung it in a minute. Feel that I'm giving as much as I can, that I'm doing my part in a production. You know, and my part can only be singing with a voice that's appealing to the ear and conveying a message and emotion. And if I don't have lyrics that make sense, it's kind of hard to do that.
In the beginning, rock and roll lyrics were also pretty silly. But over the years, rock artists started dealing with more mature subjects, just as disco artists like Gloria Gaynor are doing now. Gloria is determined that the songs she sings today will keep their emotional impact intact far into the future.
I tell you something, that's typical of me. That has nothing to do with the fact that I want to make money 100 years from now. It's just Gloria Gaynor. If I buy you a gift, I am not going to buy you a bottle of perfume for the simple reason, in 2 weeks, the perfume is going to be gone. And even if you keep the bottle, you're not going to remember who gave it to you. I'm going to give you something that you're going to be wearing or that you're going to be using, or it just sits on a shelf there and it's to be admired and loved. And so you're going to remember Gloria. I want to be remembered. That's another reason why I do those kind of songs.